The British came to India for trading. They made their offices and forts in various parts of India. But eventually, the British East India Company became the major force in India. The company's troops, led by Robert Clive, defeated Siraj-ud-Daulah, the ruler of Bengal, in 1757 in the Battle of Plassey. And that was the beginning of British rule, known as British Raj in India. Under the British rule, the Indians were deprived of basic needs, socially and economically and legally discriminated against, misbehaved, mistreated, and tortured. India's first war of independence was a revolt of Indian soldiers and rulers against British rule. The rebellion by Indian troops of the British Raj started in May 1857 and continued until December 1858. During this period of India's first war of independence, many social and religious leaders worked to inspire the Indian society. They included men like Swami Vivekananda, Ramkrishna Dev, Sri Aurobindo, Subramanya Bharati, Bankim Chandra Chatterjee, Sir Syed Ahmed Khan, Rabindranath Tagore, and Dadabhai Nauroji. They spread the message of self-confidence, removing social evils, and making India free from the domination of foreign power. During the First World War, Indians gave support to the United Kingdom. About 1.3 million Indian soldiers went to many parts of Europe, Africa, and the Middle East to fight. Many Indians, including the princes and rich people of India, contributed money and materials to the war funds of the United Kingdom, anticipating change of dominion status and home rule in return. The World War first ended in 1919, and Britain owned, with the help of Indian soldiers, India was denied its promised reward. Many Indian soldiers died in foreign lands. In India, flu spread like an epidemic, killing many people. The tax rates increased in India, and prices also increased. As a result, the Indians became restless. Gandhiji returned to India from South Africa in 1915. Under the leadership of Gandhiji, Indians began to use a different method of get freedom over the next few years. In December 1929, the Indian National Congress Party agreed to start a movement for complete independence from British rule. Under Gandhiji's leadership, many movements like Satyagraha, Dandi March took place. Many Indians did not believe in such peaceful protests, claiming that the British would not give independence to Indians so easily. They believed an armed struggle was necessary to oust the British from India. Many revolutionaries and leaders emerged from time to time. Bhagat Singh, Khudiram Bosu, Binoy Badol Dinesh, Master Dasurjo Sen, Netaji Subhash Chandra Bosu were a few of them. During the Second World War, the rulers of the British Raj declared India to be a party to the war without discussing the matter with Indians and their leaders. This created a lot of dissatisfaction among Indians, and two big movements for India's independence took shape. The first was the Indian National Army of Subhash Chandra Bosu. The second was the Quit India movement of Mahatma Gandhi. Both of these leaders and the movements under their leadership shook the British Empire. As a result of many movements in small and large scale of several years, sacrifice of the heroes of Mother India, finally, on midnight of 15th August 1947, Britain handed India its formal political independence. India finally owned its most coveted freedom, but at the price of losing a part of it. Viceroy Lord Mountbatten's divide and rule policy broke our country into two pieces and gave birth to two nations, the Union of India and the Islamic Pakistan. On the day of 75th independence of India, we all Indians desire for a highly developed, transparent, corruption-free country. We also promise to contribute to India's social, economical, spiritual, technological development to build this nation into a superpower. Happy Independence Day to you all. Jai Hind.